Hey, this is Alachia.
Hi. This is Strumpet.
And this is another 5 for 5. Yes. And this time we're bringing you 5 objects that are made in the USA.
Amazingly enough.
I know. And that's not as easy as you think it would be, which is actually a kind of a social commentary at the same time, I think, regarding, you know, the United States and the amount of products we import. Because
and what gets made in America,
exactly. Yeah, that's true.
I will tell you, is maybe a social commentary too.
Yeah, I did notice here, literally, I looked at, all I had to do was look at the past 5 items I bought in Germany that weren't like, you know, products. And they were all made in Germany.
Oh, like, were they?
Yes. And I noticed the same thing in France too. It's like, you go into a French store and you buy, you buy objects and they are made in France. Like everything, like the cups, electronics, all the little microwaves, ovens, you know, like things that we would normally see China or Taiwan or, you know.
Well, because they have a lot of German electronic brands too, you know, like, I don't know, it's Siemens and Miele, isn't that German too?
I'm not sure,
but I'm pretty sure that, like, Siemens, and there's Bosch, and, and they're good, that's good stuff, too, so.
Okay. Yeah. So, do you want to go first, or shall I?
Okay.
Wait, how many, did you find 5?
Well, I have 2, and then some products.
Okay.
Like, that are disposed, well, they're like, yeah, okay.
Okay.
My first item is my saucepan. It is, and I will show you, made in the USA. It's all clad. So my saucepan, so we cook stuff in America.
That's not bad. That's not a bad product to represent the United States.
No, and they're really good quality too, which I was wondering if I would find anything in my kitchen, because most of my high-quality stuff is actually made in France, like Le Creuset and my mandolin I just got was made in France and all this stuff. And so I was sort of expecting these things not to be made in the USA, but they are. So I was really pleased that they're such good quality. Did you find 5 things?
I did find 5 things.
Oh, you did? Because you had it the other day.
Is a product, and it's a highlighter. Sharpie Accent Highlighter. There you see. Made in the USA.
Ah, cool. Sharpies are made in the USA.
Yeah, and this is the blue Sharpie, and this is made in the USA. And I was surprised. I didn't think, like, office sort of utensils would be made in the USA.
And is a 3M product?
No, this is a... I'm not sure. It says ACMIAP on it. I don't know what that means. So.
Yeah. Don't know. Wait, well done. Were you just sort of looking at your desk and like, there it was?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to do my product next and save another thing for after. Okay, so Neutrogena is made in the USA.
What is that one?
This is a deep moisture body cream. I'll show you first. Made in the USA. There. But it's interesting. It says made in the USA of domestic and foreign ingredients or something.
Oh, it's put, all the products weren't created here. So they probably had like, you know, a lot of
domestic
stuff.
And foreign components. Yeah, so that, but they actually bother to put that on the list, you know, like they actually do that. So I thought that was interesting. So, yeah, this is going to feature in a video soon-ish.
Oh, really? A review?
Yeah. It's kind of what I'm doing to prep for going to the beach.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So it's kind of, yeah.
Okay. So, also found on my desk, which I was surprised, because I literally went through all the stuff on my desk to see what was made in the USA. Scissors!
Scissors.
I don't even know what brand this is. It says patent pending right here.
Patent pending. Scissors are patent pending.
Yes, and then right here it says made in the USA. Probably don't know.
How can like scissors have a patent pending?
I don't know.
I'm not sure if I understand how that works.
And this one, I don't know. I don't think this one is made in the USA. This is the Craft Smart one. Back when I thought I was gonna do crafts and stuff. I don't know where this one's made. Stainless steel, but. Yeah, this one doesn't have patent pending on it, so I guess this is a non-patented scissor versus a patented scissor.
I don't understand. Okay. Okay. I have one thing I have to sort of get up to show you. I'm going to try and point my video camera over there. You've all seen it if you've looked at my other videos, so you know, I'm just going to tell you, Alachia, it's my cat tree.
Oh, yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. In the stairway, that was made in the USA. I'm not going to go and show you, like, the proof, but it's made by this company that's in, like, Nebraska or something, and they travel to cat shows and stuff. So, yeah,
so my is it like cat tree. It's a specialty item, though? So it's not, like, manufactured or anything?
Well, they sell them at cat shows and at PetSmart.
Oh, if they sell them, it's where they're manufactured, yeah.
Yeah, so, but they don't, like, I guess, I mean, they're not, I wouldn't say they're factory produced, but they're, yeah, so. Okay.
Okay. I was really proud of this one, Kleenex.
Are Kleenex made in the USA?
Yes, this is made in the USA. I was really shocked. Let's see. Hang on. It says made in the USA from domestic and imported material. So
yeah, same as the Neutrogena stuff. Yeah.
Okay. But Kleenex is like my favorite thing, so I was really happy that this is made in the USA because I buy a lot of this, so at least I'm supporting them.
Did you buy those in a German store or at the commissary?
Nine. I bought this at the commissary. Yeah.
Because I was wondering if, like, German ones would be made in the USA too, or if they have a special Kleenex German...
You know,
German...
Kleenex, I believe, is also has a French affiliation as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if the ones that are in France are made in France. But yeah. I don't believe that there's a German version of this that I'm aware of.
Yes. So my next thing is actually something I just got, and when it arrived, I
you had
checked.
To go out on purpose.
Yeah,
to
I
buy.
Had to go out and buy. So it's made in the USA.
Okay.
There it is.
A brownie pan.
It's not actually a brownie pan.
Oh.
It's a little deeper than a brownie pan because it is. The lasagna pan.
Oh, okay.
So, because I make a lot of lasagna, and when I do, I try to make an extra batch, and then I cut it up and freeze it in little Tupperware things so the kids can eat them. And this will help, like, when you divide up the portions, it won't, like, fall apart. So, that's the idea anyway. So, I haven't even used it yet, but another cooking. And it is a U.S. patent.
Wow. Now you have to do a review on that to tell me like how hard it is to get stuff out of that
out of
thing.
It. Yeah. It has a special spatula.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. And I am actually planning to one of the cooking days. I don't think it's going to be the next cooking day, but maybe the one after that.
Showing.
Show like how I do my batch lasagna and bolognese sauce. So.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Yum.
It is on my list, but I don't think it's the next one. So, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Ta-da!
Flashlight!
Ah! Okay. So this, I believe, is made in the USA because it says Mag Instruments, Ontario, California, USA.
Yeah, that sounds like it is.
And then it says patented in the USA right here. So I'm assuming this is made in the USA. So this thing is a heavy duty flashlight. This thing has some serious weight to it.
Yeah.
This is a good product. And then
it is a good product.
You can actually shine. This light goes is so strong. You can actually shine into your neighbor's house with this thing from your house.
James has a thing for flashlights. I'm amazed I didn't, in my room tour, sort of find any in there. I don't know where they all are. They must be in the basement. But he has all those little mag lights and LED light ones that have all the different colors and stuff. Yeah.
I love this.
By the way, they don't know that I did a room tour of their rooms.
Yeah, I was wondering how they would feel about that.
Don't, inform them.
Not to mention the fact that it was probably the most recorded size in the video ever.
Yeah. Yeah. So, is this my last thing?
Mm-hmm.
It's another product, actually. And it's a lip balm. The Jack Black lip balms are manufactured in the USA. No, it's not, actually. I found these at Ulta because this girl, Shauna, Rather Be Dancing 3, mm-hmm. she told me it was the best lip balm ever, but it's in the men's section at Ulta.
Huh.
And I looked up on Wikipedia, and it says that it has nothing to do with the actor. It's just a guy called Jack Black who designed the brand. I hate it.
Oh.
It's really intense, this is natural mint and shea butter, and the mint is really intense and makes you really, really makes your lips tingle, a lot. And that's not for me. So, but anyway, Jack Black stuff is made. I bought the face wash for my 15-year-old, manufactured in the USA. I love how some of them say made in the USA, some say manufactured, and some see this one says manufactured down. Yeah, there.
I wonder what the difference is.
I don't know. I don't know if it's just that they want to sound fancier or if it's... I don't know. I could find no clothes, none of my GE products. I thought maybe, my GE microwave or oven or something. The microwave's made in Malaysia. My Pebble Beach, the golf resort in California, fancy golf resort where they have pro golf tournaments and stuff. My Pebble Beach fleece jacket is made in Korea.
Yeah. No, I mean literally, I would have had to start really, really pulling things out like crazy if I wanted to find more than five. This was literally I was scrounging to find the fifth one. Everything is made in China, Japan, Thailand, Taiwan, the Philippines, Malaysia, Germany, France. I mean, I can't. It's just absolutely incredible. So here's my last one, which I was actually also proud of. This is a thermometer.
It's a thermometer. Oh, it's an ear one.
No.
No.
I was actually really disappointed my dildo was not made in the USA. It's made in Japan. Okay, so this is the Exergen Comfort Scanner Infrared Thermometer. And I got this for my brother, actually, but I took it back because he never used it and I loved it so much. But basically, you scan your forehead.
So it's a forehead temperature.
99.6.
You have a fever.
A little. So I love this thing so much. But this is made in the USA, U.S. Exergen Corporation, Watertown, Massachusetts.
Exergen. I want one.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
I might get one. I had a really hard time, too, because,
You sure you don't want to get the ear one instead?
Well, James doesn't like me sticking stuff in his ear.
It's not that. It didn't go that far in, the ear one.
He hates it. Because I have the brawn ear one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He hates it. But it was hard for me because, altogether we've lived in the States 6 years. No, it's more than that now, 7 years. So a lot of our stuff was bought overseas. So there wasn't anything that we bought overseas, at all.
You've only been living in the States for 6 years total? No.
Seven.
Seven.
As a couple, yeah.
Wow.
I've lived more than that in the States before I married John, but yeah.
Well, I've lived in the States all my life except for this year. And you still don't. I had the hardest time. But the thing is that, like I said, when I went to go look at the first five things I had bought in Germany, they were all made in Germany. And it's just absolutely incredible. And I don't know what that means, like, for us economy-wise. Like, is it just mean that we have a better export, import situation?
I think it means that we're struggling. I mean, I think it means that we're struggling with what kinds of jobs people should be looking for. You know, like, there are no factory jobs. And apart from, the new car plants and stuff down in the south and stuff, there really aren't that many new factory jobs in the U.S. And so I think people are sort of struggling with the fact that if you're not, a college-educated professional, then you're in the service industry, basically, because there's no, you don't make iPads here,
I wonder, what does that mean, in terms of, for the, for the general population of the United States? Does that mean, we're out of the industrial, era completely? We're all on to the service sector? I mean, that's kind of what it seems like, right?
It seems a little like that. I mean, but I think, I think it's a huge adjustment that's being made, as we sort of speak, and I think we're having a hard time with it. I don't know.
Yeah, and I don't even know. A lot of people say, this is a very indicative factor that we are going to suffer, because, we export so much. Sorry, we import so much. But I'm wondering,
that's necessarily true.
It seems like we do... We seems like we're doing okay, I don't know what the long-term, impact is financially for us by putting so much of our money, out the door. But I don't know. It's so strange because over here and everywhere else that I've been to when I visited, everything is so oriented towards the industrial sector. And I don't see that in the States, I think that just pretty much died, at the end of the era of the unions, etc. So yeah. I'm just I'm shocked, I knew it was difficult to find products made in the USA, but I had no idea how severe that was actually. And so I think we're done. there's nothing left.
I just think it's going to be a huge adjustment. I really do. I think it's something the economy has to sort of get their head around, we have to sort of readjust, because not everybody can be the engineer, so I don't know how that works employment wise everybody can't be the MIT grad who designs space shuttles or whatever, which we're not even doing either. We've outsourced even putting things into space. We've outsourced that to China. I mean, it's like we don't even take care of our own satellites up there. Well, I think that's scary, I don't know.
It's a very interesting predicament to be in terms of an American who is, patriotic or whatever. And, a lot of people are if you are truly patriotic, you should really try to do things to support the American economy, etc. But, for me, I met this guy, and he works at, I can't remember where he works. He works at some car manufacturing company. I can't remember if it was GM or something like that. Some electronics company that it was, purely American. And basically all the people there were you have to have an American car. You have to have, American things.
Yeah.
And, I was I had this huge, we talked about, Japanese cars, because I'm a big Honda fan, and he was I love a Honda, but I'd get completely beaten up if I ever showed up to work in a Honda. And I'm wondering, are we such consumers in the States that we just don't care anymore? Give us the best and cheapest product, otherwise we don't really I've never been to a store and I've never consciously said, oh, I want to buy a product that's made in the USA. I'm after a certain product, you know, and I want.
I would never care. I want the best for the cheapest price.
Right.
I don't care where it comes from.
And I think that's the general American mentality. So, I mean.
Well, I was actually listening to This Week in Law just recently, and they were talking about, you know how, I don't know if you know this, because I don't know if it was out when you came, when you left, but there's an Amazon app where you can scan the product in the store, and it will instantly one click if it's cheaper at Amazon.
Oh. No, didn't know.
And this guy was saying that he thinks we have a social responsibility to support the local, you know, store rather than buying from Amazon. He thinks we should have a social responsibility to keep the economic community and our local community alive. And I don't agree. I think people just have to adapt. I don't know. It's a hard one.
It is. I mean, I lived in Austin for a good, you know, 11 something years, and you know, that's a very sort of hippie chic town, and they are all about consignment, and they're all about local, and they're all about, you know, local music, local everything. And so I got that a lot, you know, when I was working. You know, my coworkers are very, very particular about the products they wanted to buy and what they supported, and they were very socially conscious of you know, like this idea of supporting mom and pop shops, you know, hating Walmart, hating, you know. Yeah. But there's like this weird juxtaposition. It's like, at a certain level, I suppose, if you have a financial security in your life where you can actually choose that sort of a lifestyle, because that's exactly what it is. It becomes a lifestyle to actually choose to stay local. Yes. It's just so difficult. I mean, I thought about it.
And expensive.
Yes, yes.
It can be really expensive.
You go to the grocery stores that are local and, like, the produce is out of this world. I'm like, I can't pay that much for apples and celery and stuff.
And then they're not as nice.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah. I guess I don't know. I guess I'm too much of a capitalist to do that, you know. So, yeah.
And that's the other thing. It's really hard for other people in different cultures to understand when you're brought up with a certain culture of capitalism. Product branding, the ability to have choice and to consume is just overwhelming, you know, in terms of in your mindset. I mean, it's not even a conscious choice, I think, for most people. It's a way of life.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm going to buy from Amazon rather than local because I save sales tax, you know. Yeah. I don't have to. Yeah. Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah. I wonder, does it say on Amazon when you order stuff if it's made, where it's made or manufactured?
I don't normally see that.
But I don't read all the stuff either. Yeah. You know, I don't read the whole
thing. I read the reviews. I don't read where it comes from. Again, it's never been in my mind to care, you know, like,
to consciously go,
oh, well, is this made in the USA? If it's not, I'm not buying it. That would never occur to me. Although I do know people who are like that. And that would just be too difficult for me, especially because I'm heavily into, you know, electronics and stuff. You know, like, there's no way. My Nikon, my webcam, my mouse, my keyboard, most of the components of my computer, if not all.
I would think all of mine, you know, are, imported. I would think. I didn't look, but, yeah. Yeah. Are Dell computers manufactured? Like, because I know they're based in Texas.
I know their laptops aren't.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go then. Because I know they're based in Texas, so.
Yeah, they're like, it's being currently created in Taiwan. Okay, then, and it tells you it's being shipped, you know, and okay, it's arriving in California, now it's arriving.
Yep.
Yeah,
well, that was interesting.
Yeah.
I'm just looking around. I can see nothing else just even here. I know our piano. It's a Yamaha. I doubt that's made in the U.S. Actually, it was bought in Australia, so I doubt.
It's Yamaha. Isn't that a Japanese brand?
I think it's a Japanese brand, but I think this one was
actually... They do get bought out, though.
Yeah, but I think this is actually manufactured or made or whatever in Australia. Hmm. Because everyone told us, oh, you have to get one that's Southern Hemisphere made to be able to play it, for it to be able to tune mm-hmm. right down there. But we brought it here and it has no problems. So I think that was bullshit. Yeah.
Well, I guess that was interesting.
I think it was.
Made in the USA. You're not made in the U.S.
I am actually born in the U.S. Did you
Are
know
you?
That?
I didn't know that.
No.
My so you're dad, an American citizen.
That's how come we come in and out of here so easily.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because my dad was studying for his master's at South Dakota School of Mines, and my parents were married at the time. My mom came with him for the 2 years he was there doing his master's, and that's when I was born. So
we're both made in the USA.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if I was made. I don't know.
You were...
yeah. I was born in the USA.
You were born in the USA.
Yeah.
Well, if
yeah.
she gestated in most of it in the United States, then you were made in the USA.
Yeah.
Right.
And James was. My youngest was born here. Last time we were here. Yeah.
I wish I had a little flag.
I don't think I have an Emirates flag in Steve's room. No, no.
That, you know, if I did pull out an American flag, odds are it wouldn't have been made in the USA anyway. So.
Yeah, no, it probably would have been made in China.
All right.
All right. That
Until
was
next
fun.
Time. Bye.
Bye.